Hello to you. My name is Jessie Johnson. This is the Earth's curvature, if it is curved at all, cannot be seen from 100 miles to 5,000 miles up. Look at this picture. This is illustration A. You've been taught and told this is the curvature. This is the curvature of the Earth as a whole, seen from 100 to 300 miles above it. If Earth is curved, it cannot be seen from a side view. This is a side view. Like this. Cannot be seen from a side view like this, such as this. A geometric impossibility. Once again, it is geometrically impossible for a picture like this to be taken showing a side view curve like this. The distance has to be 10,000 to 16,000 to 20,000 miles away to see this type of curvature of the whole Earth. But yet you are told this type of thing. Why is this? Because you're too close to the surface to see it. See this at 24,901 miles in circumference. At 100 miles to 5,000 miles, the curvature, if there's any, must be measured by elevation drop, or ED. At a 24,901 mile circumference, only a fraction of the surface, 100 miles to 5,000 miles above it, can be seen, and only in a specific certain way. When the public is shown astronauts supposedly 100 to 500 miles up and shown a segment of a supposed curved Earth, such as this right here, and so forth, supposed curved Earth, this view cannot be seen. Number one, if you look at the clouds in here, you will see clouds coming out this way. That means the sun is back here. But if you look at this cloud and you see the lines going here, it means the sun should be up here. So that's one thing about photoshopping a photograph, or a picture better yet, from 1948 style of photoshopping. Now, this is illustration B. Basic geometry shows the true view of this matter. Virtually all pictures by all space agencies, books, schools, mass media, movies, etc., are bogus and propaganda. This is to brainwash the hundreds of millions, purposely to deceive, deceptive, deceit, and corrupt. Now, how you reference things on the surface of the Earth is different from referencing them from 100 miles to 5,000 miles from the surface. You have to be some 10,000 to 16,000 to 20,000 miles away to see a side view of Earth as a whole, its whole disk, like this, in this manner. In this manner, you must be very far away from it, not 100 to 5,000, 100 miles to 5,000 miles. The proof in this video uses basic geometry. Now, most globe earthers, they stare in the face of proof while asking for proof because they cannot recognize it. Now, let's go to basic geometry. This here is basic geometry. Now, the first thing is a circle. This represents the Earth, this gigantic circle. This is a circle, of course, being pointed to. This here is called a chord. A chord is a straight line which connects two points of a circle, but from within the circle, inside the circle. This here is a chord section. This bulge and the chord itself, straight line and the bulge, is a chord section. This here is the radius line. Of course, the radius line is half the diameter. This here is called a tangent line. A tangent is a curved line or a straight line which touches the circle at one point and one point only. This here is called a plane. A plane in geometry is a two-dimensional object because it has width and length, but no thickness. This here is a plane when it passes through a sphere. A plane passes through a sphere, a projection of the construction of the sphere is outlined, such as these dotted lines right here. When you pass a sphere through the chord line, you will see this is the front of the sphere. Chord section becomes a three-dimensional chord section. Now, let's go to D. Illustration D here. The Earth is considered to be 24,901 miles in circumference right here. Right here is the radius line at 3,965 miles, roughly 4,000, rounded off, and divided into 1,000 miles sections right here. This here, when we take 1,000 miles here and put it up here, 1,000 miles, it becomes your ship. Becomes here, and this is 1,000 miles above the surface, and it becomes a ship where you are up here, a ship. And this here, right here, are the tangent lines touching the surface of the Earth. The tangent line, these angled lines here, are the tangent. Right here is where the tangents are. You cannot, if you are 1,000 miles above Earth, you cannot see beyond this tangent line. This is the limit of your visibility. This is your visibility limit right here, these tangent lines, because the Earth is continuously curving away from you. Therefore, you cannot see it beyond the tangent points here when it touches the tangent points. This here is the chord, of course. And to tell if the Earth is curved, you need to use a method to tell. You draw a parallel line to the chord line. This is the chord line. Draw a parallel line where the tip of the top of the bulge is. You draw a straight line tangent right here, and this will give you an elevation drop right up in here. It will tell you if the Earth is curved, if it is. Now, here is 0.1. This is what it looks like if you were 100 miles above the surface of the Earth. Here is a tangent, the tangent right here, and right here. And if you draw two parallel lines, 90 degrees to the chord line, there's a chord line right here, and you draw a circle here, this will be the totality of the Earth you will see. When you are 100 miles up, and this would be your visibility limit. This is all you can ever see if you are 100 miles above the Earth's surface. If the Earth were a round ball, that's only if. Now, let's go to E, illustration E. You, once again, you have to be 10,000, approximately 10,000 to 20,000 miles away from the Earth to see the whole disk of the Earth, the whole ball of the Earth, if the Earth were round. You can only see the cord, any cord cutting across here, any cord cutting across here, if you are 10,000 to 20,000 miles away from it, from the Earth's surface. Otherwise, if you are 1,000 miles above the Earth's surface, like here, and you're in a ship here, you draw parallel lines, two parallel lines to the cord, there's a cord line here, and a plane, as you remember, is passing through the cord line, and you have the dotted lines which show the front of the sphere cord section. This whole piece right here, the bulge and the cord, creates a cord cap, a cord section, a cord cap, if you could take it off. And this is the cord of the visibility limit. This is all you can see. This round circle here is all you could see at 1,000 miles up. You cannot see the whole Earth at 1,000 miles up. And there are two types of cords. The cord of the whole Earth itself, if it were a ball-shaped object, the cord of the whole Earth itself, if it were a ball-shaped object, and the cord of the visibility limit, because your visibility limit at all times is a circular looking thing on a ball shaped object. And if your visibility limit is not the whole thing, then it becomes a fraction of the thing, and you can draw a cord on it, a cord here on the visibility limit. This is the cord of visibility limit. And you can cut this into pieces and show it to people and tell them that it's the whole Earth itself, and it is not. You cannot see a cord of the whole Earth, if it were round, only at 10,000 to 20,000 miles away from it, not 1,000. Now, let's go to F. Oh yes, these lines right here is your tangent points. You cannot see anything beyond this tangent point, beyond that tangent point. You can't see anything. All you can see is this here. If the Earth were a round ball, you would be right here in the center with your ship looking straight in every direction, straight down as well as all around. This is all you would see, is the visibility limit, is your visibility limit. Now let's go to F. This is F. Now, if this is the whole Earth and you are 20,000, approximately 10,000 to 20,000 miles away, if you're about 20,000 miles away, you would see the whole disk of the Earth from your position over here. This is 8,000 miles in diameter, and B right here is what you would see. B right here, the second line here, B, would be around 16,000 miles away from the Earth. And right here, C, where you would be approximately 8,000 miles away. This is what all you would see is right here. The next one, 16,000, you would see it here. Around 20,000, you would just about see the whole disk of the Earth. The whole thing. This is the Earth. It represents the Earth. 8,000 mile diameter, 8,000 miles away from it to here, 8,000 more miles all the way over here, which is 16,000 miles. Once again, once again, you cannot see this vantage point of the whole Earth at 100 to 5,000 miles away if the Earth were a ball-shaped object because of its size. I want to thank everyone for listening and watching, and please share this video, subscribe, of course, but I want everyone to have a very good day.